subscribe to James the Sheriff Dixon, you motherfuckers.
Jeez, that's a little inappropriate putting a vampire on a children's cereal box, don't you think? Wait a minute. That's it! The umbrella in the sunlight? The burying stuff in his backyard? Kevin's new haircut? Mr. Devlin is a vampire!
What's going on, guys? James here to bring you another video, and it's that time again for Bad Movie Friday. And like I promised, we're doing Fred 2. So this movie is titled Night of the Living Fred. It has nothing to do with the Dawn of the Dead or anything zombie related. It's pretty much, this is the story, it's pretty much Fred thinking that his teacher is a vampire. So let me go through what the movie is about. So Fred thinks his music teacher is a vampire, so he pretty much stalks him throughout the movie. The teacher dates his mother. They break up halfway through the movie, then they get back together, and then Fred gets invited to have dinner with the teacher, and then he gets to like the teacher. So everyone in the school thinks that the teacher's a vampire after Fred posts a couple of videos about him. And then he doesn't like that after the videos are posted, he learns that he isn't actually a vampire. So he tries to convince his friends that Fred is the vampire. So he does that, and then he and the teacher become friends. That's pretty much the movie, and the mom and the teacher don't get back together because in the end the teacher actually moves because he wants to be known for him and not as somebody else. Like, there's a stupid kind of message at the end of this movie. On IMDb, there's like a 2-star rating for this movie, and it came out in 2011. As I'm rewatching these movies, I'm remembering that I did watch them as they came out. This was back when I was in high school when they came out. So, a good 6 years ago. So, that's half a decade ago almost. So, it was a long time ago. But like I said, it's pretty much Fred thinks that his teacher is a vampire. And he pretty much stalks. Fred's pretty much a stalker. Like I said overall in my other video about the first Fred movie. So, with that, IMDb, there's not much other than, I got it written down here. The director for the second Fred movie is John Fortenberry, and there is no budget for the movie. Not surprising, since it's a direct-to-Nickelodeon movie. And, the same person plays Fred, that Lucas, I can't pronounce his last name, I'm not even gonna try. And, they replaced Jeanette McCurdy, they replaced her actress from iCarly. They replaced her actress with the person who's from Victorious, who's that main character's younger sister. They replaced Judy's character, the neighbor. They replaced her character. With that, I'm going to show you my favorite clips from the movie that I liked. Because for this movie, I actually liked and like found myself enjoying watching the movie while I was watching it, because like I said, there was actually some sort of a storyline for the second movie, which kind of gives me hopes for the next one. But at the same time, there's 2 stars on IMDb. I would push this one up to a solid 3 if it were up to me. Other than that, like I said, Fred pretty much thinks his teacher's a vampire, and he's really not. That's pretty much the story. So, I will show you all my favorite clips from the movie, then I will be right back. See you all in a minute.
The gig is up, Fred. You're outnumbered.
Yeah, that might be true, Devlin, but I've got dancing pecs, this mystical tattoo, and weird techno music plays when the wind blows through my fluffy hair.
I don't see what that has to do with anything.
Yeah, besides, we have my sister.
Surrender, friend.
Okay, I'll surrender. not!
Fred!
You're gonna go, that's what you're gonna do.
Dad!
You're gonna go, find out everything there is to know about this guy. He's a wrong dude, I can feel it.
I knew it, that's just what I was thinking.
This cottage cheese is also wrong. Throw it out.
Okay.
You get a full report and you get back to me.
Where will you be?
Right here.
Wait, Dad!
You can't see me!
Yeah, I can.
All right, what do you want?
I was thirsty.
There you go.
Sunny D. All right. Thanks, Dad.
So as I've said before, the John Cena scenes are pretty much the best parts of the movie. I'm not saying they're filler because the movie is an hour and 20 minutes. But you get what I'm saying. Like I said in the beginning of the video, it's pretty much Fred thinking his teacher's a vampire from the first clip that you saw before the John Cena one. That's pretty much the entire movie. I don't really have much more thought about it, other than so far this one's the best out of the trilogy of Fred movies. So, with that, I already gave my score. It's a 3 out of... I bumped it up from 2, because I actually, like I said, I found myself enjoying watching this compared to the first Fred, which felt like it dragged on compared to watching this. You will find yourself enjoying this if you find you want to watch yourself watching this after you see me do these, after you watch this review, I should say. But yeah, let's see what the next bad movie review is going to be next week. So yeah, I'll be right back.
Careful. Not sure if you saw it, but that's Poison Ivy right there.
Poison Ivy?
Yeah. You didn't touch it, did you?
I think I know what Poison Ivy looks like. I'm not an idiot.
And I think that's all I need to see of that. So, with that, I think you know what next week's bad movie is. It's going to be Fred 3, which will complete this trilogy of Fred movies. So, with that, I am going to end it there. And I will see y'all next week with Fred 3 Camp Fred for our next Bad Movie Friday. And I will also have my Fear of the Walking Dead review, as I always do. And yeah, that's going to be it. So I'm going to end it there. This is James saying, if you like what you've been seeing, please like and subscribe for more. This is James saying, peace. I will see you on the next one, guys. I'll let Brandon Rogers take it from here. Peace, guys.
Right, I just want to shout out an amazing channel, James the Sheriff Dixon. Oh, he's such a great guy, and he is super cool for coming to the show. I'm glad I got to meet him in person, and you should subscribe.